Dear students and faculties, welcome to my channel on the subject Engineering Graphics. In this video, we'll see about the solution for the question paper JNTU Anantapur December 2019 Computer Science Engineering Graphics subject. Okay, I'm Dr.M.Senthil Kumar. Now we'll see about the solution for all the 10 questions given in the university question paper in stages. Okay, let us see the first question. The first question is two points F1 and F2 are located on a plane sheet 100 mm apart. A point P on the curve moves such that the difference of its distances from F1 and F2 always remains 50. Find the locus of the point and name the curve. Mark asymptotes and directrices. Okay. This is a question. First step is draw a line AB, on it mark F1, F2 such that it is 100 mm apart as given in the problem. The next one is mark V1 and V2 such that is 50 mm apart. The distance of V1 and V2 is equal to 50 mm, 25 plus 25, 50. The next step is after F2 on line AB, mark the points 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. It could be any distance. After that, the procedure for getting the points 1, 1, 2, 1, similarly in the bottom side 1, 2, 2, 2 and so on is with for the first point, with take this measurement, the distance of V1, 1 as radius, F1 as center, draw arc. The next step is with V2, 1 as radius, F2 as center this time, cut arc on the previous arc, thereby will be the point 1, 1. Okay. Whatever you do on the upper side, follow the similar kind of procedure in the bottom side also, thereby you will be getting the points 1, 2, 2, 2 and so on. Okay. For the second point, with the V1, 2 as radius, F1 as center, draw arc here. Then the next step is V2, 2 as radius, F2 as center, cut arc on the previous arc and get the point 2, 1. Okay. So if you follow this way, you will be getting, you can get all the points. Okay. Now join all the points by freehand in proper sequence in a single stage, you will be getting the locus or the curve. This curve is nothing but the hyperbola. One part is over now. The next part is to mark the asymptotes and directrices. For that, first let us see about the directrix. Okay. Through F2, draw a vertical line. It cuts the curve at point C. Draw line joining C, F1. Now, you have to bisect the angle F1, C, F2. Okay, if you do so, you will be getting the line CD. This CD line is the bisector of this angle F1, C, F2. Okay, this D, how you are obtaining, if you draw a bisecting angle, that will cut the line AB at one point, that point is nothing but D. Now, CD is nothing but the directrix. If you follow this similar procedure in the bottom side, you will be getting the another directrix. So, directrices part is over now. Now, we see the asymptotes. With V1, V2 as diameter, its midpoint as center, draw the circle. Next up, with the D, which is the point, the directrix, you know, through D, draw a vertical line. It cuts the circle at points G and H. If you draw line joining OG and produce it or extend it, that is one asymptote. The next asymptote is OH and produce it. So OG and OH are the asymptotes of this particular problem. Okay. So the answer for the first question is over now. Okay. If you have any doubt, pause the video, compare the answer with the given question. I think you can clarify the doubts if at all if you have by yourself. Okay. Now we move on to the next question. Question number 2. The question number 2 is, draw an ellipsoid having a generating circle of diameter 50 mm and a directing curve of radius 100 mm. Also draw a normal and a tangent at any point M on the curve. Okay. I think I have used the notation P in my problem. Okay, you can mark that as P or M or whatever it be. Okay, in my view, both is correct. Both are correct. Right? First you draw the directing curve. Okay. So with the DS center, this 100 mm as radius, draw arc first of all. You have to measure the arc length actually. This arc length AB must be equal to the circumference of the circle, and also you have to measure the angle also. First of all, you have to measure the angle of this particular sector for this arc, the directing curve. For that, the formula is theta equal to small r by capital R into 360, where small r equal to the radius of the rolling circle. Capital R is equal to the radius of the directing curve. So 25, that is 50 is the diameter, so 25 is the radius now. 25 by this 100 into 360, 90 degree. So this sector angle is 90 degree, okay, and this is the directing curve AB. Its arc length now is naturally the circumference of the rolling circle, okay. So after drawing this directing curve on the sector with respect to this point A, draw a circle, okay, and divide this circle into 12 parts. Since you divided the circle into 12 parts, divide this arc AB is also into 12 parts. After that, with DS center, draw arcs through the points 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 5 dash, and 6 dash on the circle, rolling circle. And similarly, draw another arc with the DS center through the center of the circle. Okay, the point is, the condition is, while the circle is in rolling motion, the center of the circle will always slide on this curve, on this arc only. It is not a curve, it is arc. Okay. Now you are ready to mark the points while the circle is rolling. The procedure is, say, since you divided the circle into 12, you can go in discrete steps. That is, after 1/12 of rotation, point O dash after 1/12 of rotation, point 1 dash which is on the circle will be touching 1. So that the distance becomes 0 now. That means that much distance the A would have moved up. Okay. So that is the actual condition. Or let me tell you the procedure. After 1/12 of rotation, center O moved to O1. This is the O1 point. Okay. Similarly, this is O2, O3. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and finally 12. So after 1/12 rotation, center O moved to O1 now. Now with O1 as center, the radius of the rolling circle, 25 as radius, cut arc on the arc which is drawn through O dash with the DS center. So this is 1/1 now. Cutting point 1/1 is obtained. Similarly for 2/1, O2 as center, 25 as radius, cut arc on this arc which is passing through 2 dash point. Follow the similar kind of procedure for getting the points 3/1, 4/1, 5/1, 6/1 and so on. Join all the points by freehand, that is the epicycloid. So the first part is over as per the question. The second part of the question is, also draw a normal and tangent on a point M. Okay, in the question they asked M, but I use the notation as P. First step is mark P somewhere on the curve, epicycloid. After that, with the 25 as radius, cut arc on the arc which is passing through the center O with the DS center. Mark that point as Q. Next step, draw line joining Q, D. While doing it so, you will be getting an intercept R on the arc AB. Now draw line joining RP, that is the required normal line of the point P or point M. Okay, using meter of the scale, if you draw a line perpendicular to it, that is nothing but the line ST, which is the required tangent for this particular problem. Okay, this is the answer. As I said earlier, if you have any doubt, pause the video, understand the problem by yourself. Okay, now we move on to the next question, the third question. An area of 144 square kilometer on a map represents an area of 36 square kilometer on the field. Find the RF, representative factor, or the representative fraction of the scale of the map, and draw a diagonal scale to show kilometer, hectometer and decameter, and to measure up to 10 kilometer. Indicate on the scale a distance 7 kilometer, 5 hectometer and 6 decimeter. Right, so you have to provide the two different answers. The first answer will be finding RF. The next answer is you have to mark the distance 7.56. okay, so first RF, the formula for RF is drawing area by actual area. As per the question, the drawing area is 144, the actual area is 36. The 144 is in centimeter, 36 is in kilometer, right? So 144 is in centimeter, convert this kilometer into centimeter. Now 36, that is 144 divided by 36 into 1000 into 100. Okay, so now you have converted this into centimeter now. So the RF now is 1/25,000. With this RF factor, go for the drawing the diagonal scale. So diagonal scale, the first you draw the x line. I could say this is x line or the horizontal line. This horizontal line will be the 10 kilometer into RF. Convert this kilometer into the millimeter. Actually, I think it will be around 400 millimeter. The total length of this horizontal red color horizontal line will be equal to 400 mm. Okay, that measures up to 10. Now that measure, that is exactly equal to 10 kilometer. Now, since it is 10 kilometer, divide this line, red color line, by 12 division. So each division represents 1 kilometer. Okay, in the first one, again you divide that again into 10 subdivisions. So each subdivision is equal to 1 hectometer. So you divided the full line into 10. So each division is representing 1 kilometer. And the first division you subdivided again into 10. So each subdivision is equal to 1 hectometer. The next step is, through this left end, draw a vertical line. Its length could be anything. Okay, then divide that also into 10 equal divisions. Okay, with respect to this 10 divisions and that 10 division, complete the grid. After that, you see here, see carefully, the next step is, through the ninth point. So okay, if you measure this 0 to this distance, this is equal to 9 hectometer. Join this ninth division into the top left portion. Now it is not a vertical line, it is a inclined line. Okay, so initially it starts from ninth hectometer point, but at the top it ends at 10th hectometer. Okay, so that is why it is called the diagonal scale. Okay, the actual point is when it travels at an inclined path, initially if you measure the distance of this point from here to 0, it is 9 hectometer. If you measure the same at here, it is not equal to 9 now, it is 9.1 hectometer, or 9 hectometer 1 decimeter. Okay, I think you got the point now. After parallel to this, using the meter of the scale, draw the remaining 9 inclined lines. So now you have completed the diagonal scale, right? Now you go for the marking the distance 7.56. so the seventh point, you can take this 7 and you can mark the cues somewhere on this vertical line only. But let us see about the left point P. It is 5 hectometers. So through 5 you start traveling up to 6th division. in decimeter. Start from 5 in the main subdivision on XY, X line. In the vertical side, end at stop at the 6th point on the decimeter scale. Mark this point as P. So the distance of P from this zero vertical, the vertical line which is passing through zero, you know, it is now equal to 5 hectometer 6 decimeter or 0.56 kilometer. Then the right hand horizontal to P, point P, mark Q on a line passing through 7. Now the distance PQ is equal to 7.56, 7 kilometer, 5 hectometer and 6 decimeter. You got it? If you have any doubt, pause the video, understand the problem thoroughly. Let us move on to the next problem. Problem number 4 is a procession of points. 5 points are given. Okay, with a common reference, you have to mark the projection of all the 5 points. Okay, so the question is available in the answer slide also. Okay, now this is the question. Further, this is the answer. Point number first one, point P, 20 above, 30 in front. P dash is 20 above, P top view point P is 30 in front, 30 below XY. Next one, point Q, 35 above, 45 behind. Point R, 42 below, 55 behind. Point S, 35 below, 52 in front. Point V, in VP, 45 above HP. This is the answer. Okay. Now we move on to the next problem. Problem number 5. A line AB 70 mm long, one end A 10 above, 15 in front. Front view measures 50, top view measures 60. Draw the projection and find two inclinations theta and pi. Okay, so this is the question. The first step is, after drawing XY, mark one end A dash 10 above, A 15 in front. After that, using this front view top view, try to complete the preliminary front view set and preliminary top view set. Okay, let me tell you how to get the complete the preliminary front view set. In the preliminary front view set, this is the preliminary front view set. In that, this must show true length and true angle theta, and this will be showing the top view length. The top view length is given already here in the problem. The top view measures 60. So through A, draw line AB1 which is equal to 60. So B1 is marked. From B1, draw a projector. After that, set the composite 70, that is the true length of the line, with A dash as center, 70 mm as radius, cut arc on this projector and get B1 dash. So A dash B1 dash is equal to true length 70, which serves the true length. Its inclination is the true inclination with HP, that is nothing but you measure it and mark it separately, theta equal to 31 degree. So the preliminary front view set is over. In the preliminary top view set, this is the preliminary top view set. In this preliminary top view set, the AB2 shows the true length and true angle pi. The corresponding front view will show the front view length. In the question, the front view length is 50. So from A dash, draw a horizontal line. Mark B dash, B2 dash, such that A dash, B2 dash is equal to 50. Next step, through B2 dash, draw a projector. Next step, with A as center, 70 mm true length as radius, cut arc and get B2. So AB2 is the true length, its angle, measure the angle and mark it as pi. Pi is equal to 44 now. So you have completed both the preliminary front view set and preliminary top view set. After that, you can easily complete the problem. Okay, after that, the steps are very standard also as well. Draw locus through B1 dash, locus through B2. Next step, A dash as center, A dash B2 dash as radius, draw arc and get B dash on this locus. Draw line joining A dash B dash, that is the final front view in the top view side. A as center, A B1 as radius, draw arc, get point B on this locus. Draw line joining AB, that is the final top view. As the final check, draw a projector from B dash, it must pass through B. So we have complete, you have completed the answer for this particular question. So this is the final projection, theta 31 degrees, pi 45 degrees. Okay. Now we move on to the next problem, problem number 6. A pentagonal plane ABCDE 45 side has its plane inclined 45 degrees to HP. Its diameter joining the vertex B to the midpoint F of the base DE is inclined at 30 degrees to XY line. Draw its projections keeping the corner B nearer to VP. So here the first inclination is inclined to HP. That means you have to assume that initially it is parallel or in HP. That means you have to start from the top view. Start from the top view. In top view, draw the pentagon such that one edge ED is parallel to VP, the left extreme is a point. With respect to the point, this point or the vertex only will be tilting the entire plane. So initial front view, initial top view, and this is the initial front view. The second front view, you tilt this B dash D dash line such that it is inclined at 45 degrees to HP. 45 degrees to HP. After tilting, this is the first second front view. Draw projectors horizontal lines, thereby will be getting the second top view. Read the problem. Its diameter joining the vertex B to the midpoint F of base DE is inclined at XY. Now I have marked F here. I have drawn a line joining B1F. So it is parallel to XY now. But you have to tilt such that this line should be inclined at 30 degrees to XY. So I have drawn this line here first, inclined at an angle of 30. I am on this 30 degree line, I marked B1F. With respect to B1F, complete the third and final top. Okay. Then draw projectors horizontal lines. Thereby you can get the points for the third and final front view. Draw line joining all the 5 points and get and complete and get the third and final front view. Now we move on to the seventh problem now. Okay, this is the answer for the sixth one. We move on to the second, seventh. Again, as I told earlier, again and again repeating the same statement, pause the video. If you have any doubt, pause the video and see the answer after correlating the answer with the question. Seventh one. Hexagonal prism with the side of base 25, axis 60 mm long, resting on one of its rectangular faces on HP. Draw the projection of the prism when it is inclined at 45 degrees VP. Now one rectangular face is on HP. Okay. So you can get the solution by two ways. Okay. One is, first you have to you can assume that full hexagon is standing vertical, then you have to tilt through 90 degrees, so then the rectangular face is on the ground. So initial top view front view you have to draw. After tilting, the rectangular face should be on HP. That means you will be getting second set of front view top view. Then you have to tilt the second top view such that it is inclined at 45 degree. So third set of top view front view will be you have to draw. That is one way. The other way is you can start from side view. Okay. If you draw the end, either the top face or the base hexagon in side view, that means initially the axis is parallel to both HP and VP. You cannot see the end, the base or the top face in both front view and top view. That is the other method. Okay, I'll be following the second way, right? So draw XY, X1, Y1, because this is the separator. The XY and X1, Y1 are the separators for this side view. In side view, especially I have drawn the right side view. On the right side view, I have drawn the hexagon such that one edge, EF, E double dash, F double dash is on XY. Means it is not an edge actually, it is a rectangular face. Now one rectangular face is on the ground. So side view is over. Draw horizontal line. Okay, arbitrarily you can fix one end here. With respect to that, after measuring 60, you can mark the other end. So thereby you can complete the front view. Combining this front view and top view, after drawing the meter line, draw projectors and through these intercepts draw horizontal lines, draw projectors from different viewpoints, thereby you can complete the top view. So up to this it is over. After that you go for the tilt. You have to tilt this solid such that the prism, when it is inclined at 45 degrees to VP, okay, the axis is parallel to VP now. That axis must be inclined at 45 degrees now. Okay, tilt this entire solid inclined at an angle 45. Okay, so this is the final top view. With respect to this final top view, drop projectors and horizontal lines, thereby you can complete the and get the final front view. Okay, to get this final front view, the observer has to see this top view from this end. For this observer, this point is the farthest point. So there are three lines passing through that point. The three edges are hidden. All other edges are visible. Okay, so this is the answer for the question number 7. We move on to the next question, question number 8. A pentagonal pyramid, side of base 30 mm, height 50 mm, stands with its base on HP, and an edge of the base is parallel to VP and nearer to it. It is cut by a plane parallel to VP, inclined at 40 degrees to HP, and passing through a point on the axis 32 mm above the base. Draw sectional top view. Develop the lateral surface of the truncated pyramid. It has got three components. One is you have to draw the projection of the solid first, then section, that is a sectional front view and sectional top view next. The third one is to go for the development. So it has got three stages. So first stage, draw the projection. I have drawn the base in top view such that one base edge is parallel to VP. The base edge ED is parallel to XY, parallel to VP. Okay, so with respect to that, I completed the corresponding front view also. So the projection part is over. Then comes to the section part, sectioning part. So I introduce the section line. Sectional plane is seen as a line in front view because it is perpendicular to VP, inclined at an angle of 40 degrees to HP, meeting the axis at 32 mm above the base. So 32 mm above the base, inclined at 40 degrees, I have drawn this sectional plane. It cuts all five slant edges. I marked the five cutting points, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So except a point, cutting point number 2, all other points you can straight away get it by just drawing projectors from the front view. For cutting point 2, which is already the corresponding slant edge OD, is also a vertical line. So you cannot get it straight away. For that, temporarily you transfer this cutting point onto any other adjacent slant edge. I transfer to OA slant edge. From that, draw a projector, get the corresponding point on here, and then I have drawn an arc, okay, by drawing an arc, thereby I have transferred the point to. So draw line joining 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So thereby you will be completing the sectional top view. Sectional top view. Okay, then hatch it. Then the third component is the development of the lateral surface. So here in top view, you see all the five slant edges, OA, OB, OC, OD, OE. All the five slant edges, no slant edge is parallel to XY. No slant edge is parallel to VP. That means no slant edge in the front view will show the true slant length or the true length, TSL, true slant length. So for that you have to follow a separate procedure. In this case, I chose the slant edge OC, it is inclined now. Okay, by drawing an arc here, I made it parallel. Now OC is inclined to XY, but after tilting it, after rotating it, OC1 is parallel to XY. That means its corresponding front view will show the true slant length. Okay, so draw arc make it parallel to xy. Mark this point as C1. From C1, draw a projector, get C1 dash on xy. Now, if you draw a line joining O dash C1 dash, that shows the true slant length. With this length and by following the radial line method, go for the full development. So, in the full development, you see capital OC here is equal to O dash C1 dash from the front view. So, the TSL is very important as far as the development of a pyramid or the cone is concerned. Okay. That is one point. Okay. Then this is the full development, of course. You have to transfer the cutting points onto this development, you know, the 5 cutting points, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. For that, the procedure is transfer all the cutting points in the front view onto TSL by drawing horizontal lines. So I have drawn horizontal line. You see here, through 1 dash, I draw horizontal line. I drew the horizontal lines through 5 dash, 2 dash, 4 dash, and 3 dash, and so on. To mark point number 1, okay, take this distance, the distance of O dash from this on TSL. With this as radius, capital O as center, get the point on the slant edge OA. Because cutting point 1 is on, 1 dash is on O dash A dash. Cutting point 2 is on 1 dash B dash. So 2 must be on capital OB. Okay, that is, it follows a similar way, thereby you can get the points on to the development, the points 2, 3, 4 and 5. The next important point is, I supposed to tell you at the initial stage itself while I discuss about the development component. I chose C as the start because you see here in the front view, the height of C dash 3 dash is having the least height. Okay, so it is always advisable to consider the least height portion remaining as the start for the opening and closing or wrapping and unwrapping when it comes to development. Okay, now you obtained all the 5 cutting points on the development. Darken all the visible edges by using the thick continuous line type. Okay, leave other lines and edges as thin. So thereby you will be completing the development component also for this particular problem. So the problem number 8 is over. Okay, if you have any doubt, again pause the video, see the answer, then you play after that, after clarification. Now we move on to the problem number 9. Problem number 9 is, you are given with the orthographic view of the object. For that, you have to draw the isometric view for the same. Okay, I hope I did not explain much about this one because the shape of the object itself is a complex shape. I cannot, it is very difficult even for me to describe it in words actually, right? So this is the question given to you with respect to this, draw the isometric view. So this is the question and this is the answer. Okay, as I said, in all the problems, you, in this particular case, you have to definitely pause this video. Okay, don't play the video, right? Because I won't give an explanation for this particular thing. Pause the video, correlate the answer with this question. Okay, then get to know the things in detail by observing both the answer and the question carefully, right? Okay, now we move on to the final 10th question in this question paper, right? So this is the 10th question. The 10th question is again is a standard thing, right? You are given with the isometric view of the object. For this, you have to draw the 3 different orthographic views: front view, top view, and one side view. Here, you have to draw the right side view. Here, an indication is given to you. This is the indication for the front view. So this is the view direction for the front view, view direction for the top view. For the right side, you have to look at from this end. If you look at from this end, that is nothing but the right side view. For this right side view, you cannot see this 30 diameter circle and this rib. If you are asked to draw the left side view, you can see the rib and you can see all the two circles also. But when it comes to right side view, this 30 circle is hidden, this rib is hidden, right? Again, it is self-explanatory. I need not explain the answer in detail. Okay, you please pause the video. Okay, compare the answer with the question given to you. Okay, you will get to know the solution for this particular question by yourself. Okay, one important note in this particular case is you are asked to draw the freehand. So I have drawn the three different orthographic sections. This is the front view, top view, and right side view by using scale and compass. But you have to draw entire thing by freehand proportionately. So that is one important note here. Okay. Students and faculties, I hope you have understood the concepts and the logic for getting the solution for all the 10 questions given in this question paper. Okay. For the students especially, good luck. I hope you will gain the confidence that you will be getting good marks or at least a pass mark for on this particular subject in this examination. Okay. For the faculties, I hope at least you have got some inputs from my video which is uploaded on YouTube about this particular examination question paper is concerned. Okay. So best of luck to all of you.